Welcome students, I hope that you are fine. We can start now our lesson, Unit 5, Lesson 7. Now, our today lesson is about the reciprocal functions of the basic trigonometric functions. Students, before I start the reciprocal functions, do you remember what was basic trigonometric functions? Can you call them? Are they mahasutan? What are basic trigonometric functions? In time number 11, reciprocal trigonometric functions. Because if we don't know that part is, again this part will become simple. But I hope that you know. Okay, our today lesson is this, the cosecant, secant, and cotangent functions. Now, in the trigonometric functions, we will have six functions. Three of them are called basic trigonometric functions, while three of them are called the reciprocal functions. So the basic trigonometric functions that we have learned were sine, cosine, and the tangent. And these three, the cosecant and secant and cotangent functions, are called the reciprocal functions of the basic trigonometric functions. You know the word reciprocal even. Now, we will see the definition. If theta is an angle in standard position and B of x, y is a point on the terminal side of theta different from the origin, and r is the distance of point B from the origin, or then look, this is the graph, this is angle theta, angle theta in standard position, r is the distance from the origin to the point B. The point B is on the terminal side of theta. So what do you remember our previous lesson? Can you differentiate which side is the oversight, which side is the adjacent, which side is the abutilis? Ardayay, ma kala soo kala soo kartaan dhinacyada saddex xagal ka taal halka nooga sameysmay. Dhinacyada adjacent ka ma soo saari karta? Dhinacyada abutilis ka ma sheegi karta? Kii oversight ka ma sheegi karta? I hope that you can. If you know that, then this will become simple again. So let us see. Cosecant theta is equal to what? Hypotenuse over oversides. Look, what is our hypotenuse? It is R. You remember, we said hypotenuse, the longest side, or the side that is opposite to the 90 degree angle, we said. So R over oversight, our angle is opposite to the Y axis, the vertical line, Y. So we call it Y. Second, theta is equal to what? Hypotenuse over adjacent. From this figure, you can see the hypotenuse is still, it is R. The adjacent is what? X. So we'll take these definitions. And cotangent theta is equal to what? Adjacent over oversight. So these functions are called the reciprocal functions. How many functions are the reciprocal functions? Three functions, don't forget. What are they? Cosecant, secant, and cotangent. Also, don't forget the definitions. As you remember, as you didn't forget the previous definitions of the basic trigonometric functions, don't forget also these definitions. Cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse over oversight. Sec theta is equal to adjacent over, and hypotenuse over adjacent. Cotangent theta is equal to what? Adjacent over oversight. So, I am sure that you are familiar with. So, CSC theta, sec theta, cotangent theta are what? Are abbreviations. CST tan waxa u taagan tahay waa wax la soo gaabsaday oo u taagan maxay cosecant u taagan tahay CST-dani SEC waxa u taagan tahay secant and this cot waxa u taagan tahay cotangent so these are the abbreviations of cosecant theta secant theta and cotangent theta respectively now we have already learned the most important part of our lesson students I hope that you get the necessary points now let us see the first example and use this definitions this formula clearly if theta is an angle in standard position and the point is 3,4 is a point on the terminal side of theta then evaluate what we will evaluate the cosecant secant and cotangent functions how many functions are you going to find their values three functions what do we call the three functions the reciprocal trigonometric functions cosecant theta find it secant theta find it cotangent theta find it so this is what we are expected to find in this example are you ready students to do the solution of this example I hope that you are ready isn't it now let us say the graph is this 3 and 4, both of them are positive, so it will be in the first quadrant. This is our angle in standard position theta. Can you name the oversight? Mashay karta oversight ka into unuqonayo? Masareba maforba? Mashay karta hypotenuse ka into unuqonayo? Mashay karta into unuqonayo adjacent again? Okay. Now let us see. Solution. The distance r, what do we call the distance r? It's hypotenuse. It's obtained by the Pythagoras formula. 3 square plus 4 square, which will be 9 plus 16, which is equal to what? Radical 25, and radical 25 is 5. So we got now r. Our r is what? Hypotenuse is equal to 5. Now the other is easy. Now let us see, cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse over side. So it will be 5 over 4. What about secant? Do you remember the definition, the formula of secant? Secant was what? Hypotenuse over adjacent, which is equal to 5 over 3. What about cotangent theta? It will be adjacent over oversight, which is equal to what? 3 over 4. How it was? Was it difficult? I hope it is not. Now let us see. The next example. Using the figure below, what do you see? Using this figure, we will try to find the functions. Find cosecant, secant, cotangent, theta. Can you find the students? I am sure that you can find. This is similar to the previous example. Compare sine theta with cosecant theta. Cos theta with secant theta. Tan theta with cotangent theta, okay? What is the relationship between them? Are they reciprocal of each other? How do they relate? Are they oversight? Are they reciprocal? What is the relationship between these two? Okay, now let us find the solution of this question. Let us say solution. As before, since the point B 5,12, using the Pythagoras theorem, we will get R what? 13. R stands for us as a hypotenuse. R tan waxay noo tahay ka hypotenuse. Hypotenuse ka waxaan helay 13. From this hypotenuse equal to 13, the oversight is 12, the adjacent is 5 from the figure. Now we can go directly to what we call cosecant theta is equal to what? Hypotenuse over oversight, which is equal to 13 over 12. Sec theta is equal to hypotenuse over adjacent, which is equal to 13 over 5. And cot theta is equal to what? Adjacent over oversight, which is equal to 5 over 12. Okay. What about sine, cosine, and tangent? How can we compare? This is the first question answer. How can we compare? We have a response to the question about sine iyo cosecant theta. waxa sababta dhigay inaan isku isla eegayna waxa ka dhaxeeya cos iyo sec and so on so now maxaa yeela to compare sin theta with cosecant theta cos theta with sec theta and tan theta with cotangent theta Let us see. Sine theta is equal to what? Oversight of our hypotenuse. What is our oversight? 12. What is our hypotenuse? 13. So 12 over 13 is what? Sine theta. If we compare with cosecant theta, what is cosecant theta? 13 over 12. What is the relationship between them? What is the relationship between them? Okay, let us see again. Cos theta under sec theta. Cos theta is equal to adjacent of hypotenuse, which is equal to 5 over 13, while sec theta was what? Hypotenuse over adjacent, which was 13 over 5. What's the relationship between them? Look their values, look their formulas. إيه بالقاعدة دودة إيه قيمة ياشان هاللي حريق سيدان هي كان حيال مرين إسان again tan theta is equal to what oversight of our adjacent which is equal to 12 over 5 while cotangent theta is equal to 5 over 12 what relationship what's the relationship between them محاط أران كرتا كوان مكويسك سهور جيدا ليد سكو أبا مكوى Rugal is Kuaba. Are they oversight? Are they reciprocalis? Let us see. I hope that you get the answer in the beginning of the lesson, even by my introduction. They are reciprocalis. This is their relationship. Sine is the reciprocal of cosecant theta. Or cosecant theta is the reciprocal of sine. They are reciprocal functions. Okay. Therefore, from that example we got cosecant theta is equal to 1 over sine theta, sec theta is equal to what? 1 over cos theta, and cotangent theta is equal to 1 over tan theta. Where rugal ka? Madame is queen in rugal. Cosecant theta is equal to what? How loss like sine theta? Hey? Sec theta is equal to what? How loss like cos theta? Cotangent theta is equal to what? 1 over tan theta. Okay? So if we have some value, we can easily find. Hence, cosecant theta and sine theta are reciprocalis. Again, which two? Sec theta and cos theta are reciprocalis again. Tan theta and cotangent theta are reciprocalis. Let us answer this example. If theta is 30 degrees, then find cosecant theta, sec theta, and cotangent theta. أرضيي هدي إنو فهمي إنتي يريدو هدى عشر كين هوري كوساب سان تصالحي لبات بل تصالحان إهد أيو فضيجين أنك شقين It is so simple really You know theta equal to 30 degree is a special angle What is cosecant theta? What is sec theta? What will be the value of cotangent theta when the angle is 30 degree? That means cosecant of 30 degree Sec of 30 degree and cot of 30 degree is needed from you. Waxa laga rabaa inaad soo saartay waa cosecant of 30 degree, sec of 30 degree iyo cot of 30 degree. Can you find it? Machiro graph lagu sawiray isma heli karnaa? Yes, we can get, isn't it? Let us see the solution. Cosecant theta is equal to what? 1 over sine theta. So cosecant of 30 degree will be equal to what? 1 over sine of 30 degree. 1 over sine of 30 degree. Isn't it? Sine of 30 degree is a hundred. Special angles we have learned was over 1 over 2 by hundred. How long did I? 1 over 2. 2 by the corner of the 2. Cosecant of 30 degree is equal to what? 2. Again, sec theta is equal to 2. Sec theta is equal to what? 1 over cos theta. Sec of 30 degree. Is equal to 1 over cos of 30 degree. Cos of 30 degree, do you remember? It was radical 3 over 2. So upside down, Cameroon, Hoseihi, and cos of 30 degree, Sarayan Batkadegi, Sarayan Hoseyat Kadegi. So it will become what? 2 over radical 3. So sec of 30 degree is equal to what? 2 over radical 3. If we rationalize, 2 radical 3 over 3. Cos of theta is equal to 1 over tan theta. Cos of 30 degree is equal to 1 over tan of 30 degree. So 1 over radical 3. Kala rogu. Tan of 30 degree maxay noqon jirtay? 1 over radical 3 bay ahaan jirtay. Kala rogu isdaba mari. Radical 3 over 1 bay noqon oo ah radical 3. That is the advantage of these functions. Students, now you will try this activity. But before you try this activity, do you understand what our today lesson was? If you understood, you will answer this. So try this activity. Find the values of the cosecant, secant, and cotangent of these angles. A, 60 degree. B, 240 degree. C, negative 405 degree. These angles are what? Angles that you want to find their values when we use cosecant function. That means cosecant of 30 degree. Cos of cosecant of 30 degree will be what? 60 degree will be what? And so on. Also remember that dhammaan astaamihii ay sine iyo cosine iyo secant ay lahaayeen and sine iyo cosine ay lahaayeen iyo tan ay lahaayeen saddexdan aan dhiganay u bixinay reciprocal functionskeena way yeelanayaan. Meesha sine positive ay ahaan jirtay cosecant positive ay noqon, meesha cos positive ku ahaan jirtay and sec positive ay noqon, meesha tan positive ahaan jirtay cotangent positive ba noqon. Waaxihii calaamadihii sine cosine iyo tan sidan buu kala qaadanayaan calaamadihiina. Okay, try, you have 4 minutes. Okay, I hope that you did. Now take correction and check your answers. Solution. For theta equal to 60 degree, we can find easily. Theta and throw. Cos of 60 degree is equal to 1 over sine of 60 degree. Sine of 60 degree, that's what it is. Cos of cosecant of 60 degree, what it is. What can it be? Why? Sine of 60 degree, so that's what it is. What can it be? Upside down. So it will become what? 2 over radical 3. Sec of 60 degree will be equal to what? Cos of 60 degree. And cos of 60 degree was what? 1 over 2. It's the calorogon 2. Cos of 60 degree, 1 over tan of 60 degree, which is equal to 1 over radical 3. So it will become radical 3. Okay. How it was? I hope that you get the answers. For the angle theta equal to 240 degree, محل استعمال إسا واحدة لبادوية this angle is quadrant 2. So what are you expected? حسوس على مضيه. So on the reference angle key. Also you should have to remember the quadrant it belongs to tells you whether it's positive or negative. Also it will tell you to find the reference angle. Make acute angle. حقا نبقى حيس إبر إلا سقاشن دقري وينا كان دقنا لو بقل يفرتم ويبالنتاي. So here. Cosecant of 240 degree is equal to negative cosecant of 60 degree. Because reference angle can be called degree, but it's degree and also by degree. Sine of 60 degree is equal to radical 3 over 2. Cosecant of 2 over radical 3. What is the minus sign? Around the negative, come back. Why we put this minus negative? Because of the quadrant. In quadrant 3, 240 degrees quadrant 3, not quadrant 2. So it will be what? Negative cosecant. Okay, sec of 240 degree will be negative sec of 60 degree, which will become easily negative 2. Because in quadrant 3, only tan is positive, sine, cos were negative. Also here, cosecant and the secant will be negative. Only tan will become positive. If tan become positive, which value will become again positive? Cotangent will become. So cot of 240 degree will be cot of 60 degree, which is equal to radical 3. Students, did you get? I hope that you get. C, for theta equal to negative 405 degree, this is fourth quadrant angle with reference angle 45 degree. This is cosecant of negative 405 degree is equal to negative cosecant 45 degree. So in the fourth quadrant, what is positive is only what? Cos, isn't it? In the fourth quadrant. All the others are negative. So, sec of negative 405 degree will be sec of 45 degree, which is equal to radical 2. And cot of negative 405 degree is equal to what? Negative 1. Students, that is all our today lesson. I hope you good luck. Work hard.